गुड मॉर्निंग दोस्तों, दिस इज रिगार्डिंग व्हाट आई हैव जस्ट रेड इन रीडिफ न्यूज सोर्स. वन वेरी ग्रेट ग्रेट इकोनॉमिस्ट एंड थिंकर ऑन दिस इशू हैज पुट अक्रॉस हिज व्यूज इन रीडिफ मेल विच आई थॉट शुड बी पुट अक्रॉस. यू कैन फॉरवर्ड दिस एंड सर्कुलेट. इट इज फ्रॉम द सोर्स ऑफ रीडिफ मेल दैट आई हैव कम टू नो ऑफ दिस. व्हाट इज मिस्टर आदर पूनावाला डूइंग इन यूके इन दिस टाइम ऑफ इमेंस क्राइसिस? ही इज द सीईओ and chairman of the world's largest vaccine manufacturer, Serum Institute of India, that is SII, situated in Pune, in the state of Maharashtra, India, as everyone is aware of course. He has infused around £200 million in setting up a research, development and a vaccine manufacturing facility in UK, and the first phase trial of one drop vaccine through nasal drops is already being started, which may be launched by September or October. Now, the UK Prime Minister is very sweet to our Indian Prime Minister and all the bureaucrats over here, even inviting the PM to G7 summit sometime in June or July, so that he makes him feel more powerful, one of the most powerful politicians of a very powerful nation. We are a powerful nation with our own resources, but an Indian manufacturer going and settling in UK and then saying that he is being threatened, why didn't he complain to our Indian police or ED or CBI or NCB or whatever it is? Why didn't he complain? Even the politicians over here asked him to name the persons who are threatening him. He has been given Y+ securities. When he needed money, the government has provided him with more than 2000 crore for vaccine development, place order for more than 12 crore vaccine. Where are those vaccines? Vaccine are not available in the market at all. Now, this is a very dangerous situation that right below our noses, a foreign company, a foreign prime minister of United Kingdom drags away an Indian manufacturer and wants to make itself a superpower vis-a-vis the medical facilities that will be available. They have made an offer to Adar Poonawalla to set up a $1,000 million plant over there, in which they will infuse maximum equity. That is, the government of UK will infuse maximum equity. If this is the case, then it is a very bad situation for the country, wherein a vaccine manufacturer has been towed away right below our noses, which will pose a grave danger to manufacturing and availability of vaccine for our own Indian public. Why has this happened at such an important time? After receiving the money from the central government, why has Mr. Adar Poonawalla shifted to UK now and citing all those threat calls and everything or whatever, etc., etc., and all other bullshit he has enumerated? It is like the earlier East India Company, which is again taking away our most important resource. Our Indian government should look at prioritizing first Indian community, provide vaccine, make it available, and then provide it for the entire country. Just like our US president has kept a target of vaccinating 70% of the adult population of USA by August. Where is such a target in India? Why is Mr. Adar Poonawalla sitting in UK, setting up his own factory, launching the first trial of the nasal-based one-drop vaccination against corona in UK? Why does UK want to be a superpower by taking away our manufacturer from India there? All these developments are not looking good on our part. We as Indians who are paying taxes, GST or otherwise, direct or otherwise, should have priority and should have right over such vaccination. The government should look into this. Read the Rediff Mail news in great detail. You will understand what exactly the author wants to point out. Thank you.